This video introduces the principal agent framework. In a simplest form, the game has two players. The principal has a task that needs to be done. The agent can be assigned to do the task. The principal faces a series of decisions. He first needs to decide whether or not to do the task himself or to delegate to the agent. If he decides that he wants to delegate the task, a range of new issues emerges. The principal needs to clearly specify the task so it can be communicated to the agent. He also needs to decide on which aspects of tasks are important to him. Ideally, the principal would like to hire a highly skilled and motivated agent with similar preferences as himself. Then there would be no need for controlling the agent. But more often than not, he will need to make some trade-offs. If the task is difficult, the principal's main concern might be with ability. Will the agent be able to expertly conduct the task? To secure a competent agent, the principal might be willing to hire someone with different preferences than himself. Then the scope of agency shirking introduces a different challenge. Here, the problem is that the principal cannot verify the effort put in by the agent, only the outcome. He will decide whether or not to invest own effort into uncovering the type of the agent, or decide on some rule for how to react when seeing the outcome. And then there's agency drift. It arises when there's a diversion between the principal and the agent over what's the optimal outcome. The principal might want to limit the scope for drift. He could monitor the agent's action himself or hire a second agent to flag agency drift. Now let's consider a trivial example. You're busy working on a group project and want a cup of coffee. And in fact, you want a cafe latte with a double shot of espresso. One member of the group has done her task, so you ask her to fetch the cafe latte for you so you can focus on the group project. And this is not a task that requires specialist skills, but it provides some scope for shirking. She might go for a latte with a single shot, expecting that you will not notice. After all, a single shot latte is cheaper. And you might perhaps prevent this if you require her to verify the order by providing a receipt. Also, she must simply decide that the time it takes to wait for the barista to make the latte is not worth it. So she will just order black coffee. While this is not the cafe latte with a double shot of espresso that you wanted, it's nevertheless coffee. And as a result of this experience, you might decide that it's better to buy your own coffee the next time. Now, successful delegation from one principal to an agent might already be difficult. Yet further complication arises when there's a group of principals that want to delegate a task to an agent, as they might differ in their assessment of the risk associated with delegation. And as a result, they may also differ in the need for costly control mechanism. So there might be more scope for agency drift when delegation is on behalf of a group of principals rather than just one. To illustrate, consider a situation where there's three governments that want to form a union to foster political and economic integration. While sharing the goal, the government differ on what they consider the optimal level of integration, as well as the optimal policy on the left-right, the policy dimension. These positions can be illustrated in the figure. Government A wants most integration and is relatively centrist on the left-right dimension. In contrast, Government B is relatively reluctant to integrate and would furthermore prefer leftist policies. Now, Government C is somewhat more integrationist than B, but would like to see right-wing policies adopted. And after some initial negotiations, the three governments have agreed on a package of moderate integrationist and centrist policies, X. They have also concluded on a commission in charge of the process. The commission prefers as much integration as Government A and almost as leftist policies as Government B. Government C is worried that the commission might want to implement Y with the support from the other governments. She will thus insist on some control mechanism. Effective mechanism for reducing drift are costly, and the other governments are not particularly interested in funding such measures. After all, they would benefit from some agency drift. As a result, the control mechanisms are less than perfect, but they are nevertheless sufficient to limit the extent of drift to Z, and all governments can agree to this. It is further to the left than government A would prefer, but it's more integrationist than X. And although it's more integrationist than government B would prefer, it's more leftist than X. And finally, for government C, it's better than the resulting policy set that would have happened if there were no control in place. So to sum up, the video has introduced the principal agent framework. When delegating a task to an agent, the principal needs to consider the need for expertise as well as the scope for shirking and agency drift. While agency shirking and drift can be limited by a monitoring and control mechanism, such mechanisms are often costly. If excessive, they might outweigh the benefit of delegating in the first place. When a group of principals delegate to an agent, the scope for agency drift might grow as the principal might differ in the assessment of the consequences of the drift.